Ladies and gentlemen, members of the press, I see you are all settled in. That's very good. Truth of the matter is, this is the first of the events that I have anchored that I see that this particular segment of the program is actually the first, as opposed to being item 7, which is amazingly good. On the 29th of September, 1960, a private limited liability company was incorporated. Of course, with a paid up share capital of 1 million naira. That's at 1960. And of course, eventually converted to a public company in 1978. It doesn't stop there. Of course, wheat milling is the financial backbone of this amazing company, thus making them the pioneers of flour milling in Nigeria. This they started by when they commissioned their first flour mill in 1962, ladies and gentlemen. And as at that time, it had a production capacity of 500 metric tons. Today, it has a production capacity. It boasts of a production capacity of about 8,000 metric tons, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, this company, this brand, this household name, which has over the years, I'm talking of then to now, decades, has been feeding the nation. This company was founded by an amazing individual whose legacy lives on. Ladies and gentlemen, as a matter of fact, he's referred to as a legend. Even in death, he has left an indelible mark in the lives of people, in the footprints of time, ladies and gentlemen. We're all gathered here today because, in one way or the other, he has positively affected our lives. Thank you so much for coming forth. We appreciate you. We are set to get into the proceedings for the day. Ladies and gentlemen, and to formally welcome you, please help me as I welcome to the podium the Group Managing Director of Flour Mills of Nigeria PLC, Mr. Paul Bededo. A round of applause for him as he comes, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.
Your Excellencies, Royal Highnesses, distinguished senators, captains of organized private sector, honorable members, distinguished guests, members of the press, my colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, it is my humble privilege to welcome you all to this special memorial occasion for a great man, a truly rare breed. Someone commented about him, they don't make them anymore. For over 50 years, Mr. George Stavros Coumantaros, our chairman, led FMN. He led FMN from a single mill company in Apapa to become the largest food and agro-allied group in Nigeria. He did so with uncommon demonstration of professionalism, engineering, passion, and large-heartedness. Everybody loved to be associated with him, and we all call him Baba. He had an exceptionally sharp memory which he maintained till his death. It was always interesting to watch him comb every nook and crannies of FMN Mills and premises during his visits. You don't tell him where to tour. He took the lead. Those of us he mentored and who became business leaders under him will forever be grateful to him for his down-to-earth and dispassionate approach to discipline. He was committed to training and giving leadership opportunities to Nigerians who proved themselves qualified and loyal to the company. Our chairman believed in Nigeria and worked tirelessly in difficult times, albeit in the background, for the unity and survival of this country, Nigeria. For over 50 years, he saw not less than 10 heads of government of Nigeria and cooperated with them through his group of companies in providing food, supplies, and employment to Nigerians. His enduring leadership has provided a model for his successor and employees to follow. Truly, he's our chairman emeritus, chairman forever. We, all stakeholders of FMN, will work to maintain his legacy. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, once again, I welcome you to this memorial event.
The chairman of the Flour Mill of Nigeria, Mr. John Coumantaros. My friends, ladies and gentlemen, this is a solemn occasion in our lives. And for me, a great privilege to pay tribute to a worthy friend, to a trusted friend. I met Mr. George Coumantaros in about August 1968. Mr. Coumantaros followed my career throughout the rest of my time in the civil service and thereafter and until today. I believe I'm not alone. Mr. Coumantaros has made similar friends, has made similar impacts, mentored many people. I think he went beyond the call of duty. I have said it before, and I want to say now, that he is the best manager of man and resources. I have watched him. I have watched him as a member of the board of the flour mill, as his vice chairman of the company, and I have seen how he has operated. He is a man who, once he makes a friend, he remains friends for life. I think sometime in 1978, there was an explosion in the flour mill of Nigeria. I believe one or two people died, and some people received severe injuries. I got to know, and I witnessed it, that he personally supervised the rescue operation, the evacuation of the wounded, and their treatment in hospitals in Nigeria and abroad. That night, I was with him. And I've never seen a man so sad and so worried about his people. Flour mill is a company employing more than 20,000 people, directly and indirectly. I don't remember of any labor crisis in that company. And I believe that it is because of the way and manner he has founded and managed this company for more than half a century. It is rare for such cordial relationship to exist between a company and its workers. I wish the company continued success and prosperity. Thank you, ladies.
The next person to come on stage to give his tribute, ladies and gentlemen, please help me as I welcome on stage Professor Jerry Gunner. A round of applause for him, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.
Your Excellency, the Chairman of the Board of Directors of Flour Mills of Nigeria, the very distinguished directors, former and present directors, Your Excellency, the former Minister of Defense, my very big brother, General T.Y. Danjuma, and his lovely wife, other very distinguished senators, governors, distinguished Nigerians here present, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I came to meet our Chairman Emeritus, the one we are remembering and celebrating today because he did an excellent job in Nigeria. I came to know him a few years back when the company wanted to expand into sugar plantations as a very wise decision of growing some of their raw materials. I come from Niger State, and one of the blessings a state like that, like Taraba, like Benue, like other states in the Middle Belt, we have huge land resources. So when Sunti sugar became available, and it was being sold, I was crazy enough to bid for Sunti sugar, and I succeeded in acquiring about 16,000 hectares of just land for sugar plantation. After acquisition, I had no idea what to do with it because I don't have the money. And then one of my former students at Ahmadu Bello University, who works with flour mills, introduced my sugar plantation to our great chairman. And before I knew it, they sent a team to me in Niger State on the farm at Kudu and also Sunti. And that started the story. And therefore, whenever I introduced myself with the flour mills, I said, the chairman, we met, sugar brought us together. So our relationship has been very, very sweet, because it was always so wonderful, so gracious, so lovely. It was not long before they really invested into sugar plantation, and I want to take this opportunity to salute his wisdom, to salute his determination, to salute his love for Nigeria, to salute the fact that he would like to really create jobs for Nigerians. Today at Sunti, there is not only a sugar factory, but directly and indirectly, over 10,000 people are working in that plantation by now. And therefore, the people of Niger, through that intervention, are extremely grateful to our Chairman Emeritus, who saw that value and came in, did not mind my inexperience in business, discussed, acquired, and invested. When I left government and I was associated now with the flour mills, and I wanted to be in the private sector. One day I asked him, you've been in the private sector for so long, you've succeeded, you've done very well, you've kept out of all sorts of troubles. What is your advice to me? I'm trying now to come from academia through government into the private sector. He said, Jerry, if you want to succeed in the private sector, keep your mouth shut. And you know, haven't been Minister of Information, haven't been Director of MAMSA talking everywhere. That was the best advice I ever got. And therefore now in the private sector, I keep my mouth shut. I saw in him someone who truly loves excellence. I admire tremendously because he has a gift of taking wise decisions. And once he has taken the decision, he's very resolute to see things happen. We salute his memory. May his soul rest in perfect peace. And I wish John and all the members of the family and all of us, the members of the family of Flour Mills, Chairman Emeritus has led the way excellently, came into Nigeria since 1960. He has invested, he has produced, he has led, he has inspired, he has really motivated, he's done very, very well. John, may you do even better. You will move Flour Mills forward. Like your father found me, may you find others and also build them. Kindly put your hands together for our chairman. Can I hear you?
The chairman of Flour Mills of Nigeria PLC, Mr. John Coumantaros, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. The thing about Mr. George Coumantaros was that he could meet somebody, listen to them, and make up his mind very, very quickly whether this was the kind of person he wanted to do business with and wanted to support. Now, that is a phenomenal skill, because when you bear in mind that he was very successful, if he was taking decisions so impulsively, it meant he had the right instincts and he could see through a human being very quickly and decide who to back and who not to back. So many, many, many years later, when I retired as CEO of IBTC, the bank, he then invited me to join the board of Flour Mills of Nigeria PLC. And of course, there was only one answer, which was to say yes, which is why I'm on the board today. And all I want to do is to use this opportunity to say thank you to Mr. George Coumantaros. Thank you to his family. And I hope and pray that in the same way that he helped to bring up young Nigerians like me and supported us to succeed in our various endeavors, I pray that you keep his memories alive in the same way and identify young people that you will support and back, because that is really the legacy of Mr. George Coumantaros.
A lot has been said about this great man, this legend, this industry icon, but very few know a lot about him. So sit back and watch as we play for you this very brief video, The Lives and Times of George Stavros Coumantaros. Thank you very much.
George Stavros Coumantaros, international renowned businessman and veteran ocean racer, passed away peacefully in Athens, Greece on October 17, 2016, overlooking his beloved Mediterranean Sea. He was 94 years old. George was born on July 23, 1922 in London and spent his early years in Greece. At the age of 26, he moved to Buenos Aires, Argentina, with his parents and sister. In Buenos Aires, he worked for a major grain trading company and simultaneously expanded his knowledge of shipping and flour milling, which has been in the family business for many years. He moved to New York in 1947 and established the Southern Star Shipping Company Incorporated that began operating dry cargo ships and tankers under the World War II Maritime Act. In a shipping career spanning 70 years, George Coumantaros established many long-term commercial relationships with international companies in the industrial steel, aluminium, coal, cement, and petroleum sectors. He serviced the industrial needs and provided highly innovative logistical solutions for several multinational industrial and grain companies. He developed a reputation within the international maritime trade and industrial sectors for his integrity and vision, as well as his boundless energy, creativity, and resolve. In 1960, Nigeria sought investment in industry, and George seized the opportunity to establish a flour mill days before Nigeria's independence. Under his wise and pioneering leadership, the company grew tremendously and expanded into other consumer food-related products and agro-allied activities. The company got listed on the Nigerian Stock Exchange in 1978 under the name Flour Mills of Nigeria PLC and currently employs over 12,000 people who look up to him as a protector and father figure. Over the past 55 years in Nigeria, he has built a reputation of integrity and has become extremely well respected within the Nigerian community for his undeterred commitment to Nigeria's economic and social advancement as a leading nation of Africa. George was a devoted sailor, being closely involved in the designing of his yachts, all which he skippered himself. He was also very involved in his racing teams, competing in many ocean races over a 52-year period, among which was the famous Fastnet race in 1979, first to finish in Bermuda five times and winning the Newport Bermuda Trophy. In ocean racing circles, he was well known for the outstanding quality of his sailing program, with hundreds of young men and women coming through the program. George was a generous philanthropist who gave to many projects he believed in, a grand archon of the Greek Orthodox Church, and a vibrant member of the Greek community in New York. With his charismatic and genial personality, whether in the sailing world, the business world, or in any aspect of his life, George had many friends. He was well loved and respected for his unparalleled integrity and foresight. He was an inspiration to his family and his employees, and he'll be greatly missed, not only by his loved ones, but also by all whose lives he touched.
Goodbye, everybody. Thank you for coming.
Very much for your patience. A round of applause for him. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. We're almost done. Like I assured you earlier, everything will move in a timely and orderly manner. We'll be out of here in no time. Thank you very much. I'd like to invite to the podium one who had a very close relationship with him, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, that he will depict in the eulogy, ladies and gentlemen, that he's going to come on stage to give to us. Please help me in welcome Mr. Thrasis Mazarakis for his eulogy. A round of applause for him.
Good afternoon. Papu to the Greeks, the chairman to us all. A man of extraordinary charisma who engendered immediate respect and exuded an old age dignity, but at the same time was amazingly forward-thinking and incredibly approachable. I would like to share some insights into George Coumantaros, the businessman, on behalf of our 13,000 employees. Mr. Coumantaros was a very intuitive businessman, a man who communicated easily, looked at problems from all the angles, collected the data points he needed to make decisions, and when he had enough to make a decision, he had strong, but not immovable, opinions. And yet, he never imposed these opinions. Rather, he would gather all the parties in our boardroom, in a papa, and have a conversation, ask for our perspective. And when he heard what he wanted to hear, he would say, "That sounds right," and decreed it would be so. Everybody felt included, and nobody felt their opinion had been overlooked. He was already reaching for the phone to act on that decision while the rest of us were still ironing out the details. And once the decision was made, he moved on. He didn't second guess himself. Life was short, and there were other decisions to be made. He was a remarkably patient and understanding man when dealing with adversity, but remarkably impatient when he felt the implementation was not as fast as it could be. He often assigned tasks to a few trusted lieutenants, sometimes the same task to many of us, thereby emphasizing the urgency and his point. And he insisted on a team approach. Upon being assigned a task, one did not let him down. Mr. C's memory was strong, his follow-up consistent. He praised and rewarded his colleagues generously. We all wanted to succeed with him and for him. We would travel together to Nigeria, a country he visited hundreds of times over the past 55 years, in which he considered his second home. As one staff member wrote, quote, a senior banking executive noted, quote, he is the true Nigerian patriot. And he could have been talking about Nigeria, about Greece, or about the United States. He touched so many people, and they recognized and respected his many contributions. He was a man who, even in the darkest hours, found a way to connect, to make it fun, to make you want to follow him. He did that by telling stories, and there was always a moral to these stories, or jokes. These were repeated quite often, and for those who had heard them before, they were immediately recognizable. The circuitous route to the punchline, however, was never the same. But it didn't matter. The pleasure he got in telling the joke, the twinkle in his eye, the excited inflection in his voice, the broad smile on his face was delightful. The audience was his. On one of our trips, John and I had to leave a day earlier than he. When I asked, why didn't he leave with us? He looked at me with a wicked little smile and said, I've got to undo all the things you wise guys have done. And indeed, his intervention made things better with his personal touch, with his direct communication, with his optimistic encouragement. A couple of years ago, I took a photograph of him and gave it to a talented Nigerian painter who made a beautiful portrait which I thought really captured his bubbly spirit. I gave it to him that Christmas. He opened the card, read it carefully, and thanked me, for it was the thought conveyed in the message and not the gift itself that he most appreciated. He looked at the painting and told me he had just the place where he wanted to hang it, over my desk. Whenever there was a tricky issue to deal with, he said, I should look at him, and I would know what he would do, and he would be right, as usual. And so, there his portrait hangs, over my desk as he instructed, welcoming me every morning with a smile, encouraging our every step, and exhorting us to do it now and do it well. I will miss him so much. We will all miss him because we all loved him. This unique, visionary, loving, honorable, compassionate, energetic man, his spirit, his leadership, his presence. But he will live with us forever as we carry him with us in our souls. And he will forever be our papa, our papu, the chairman. May God bless him.
Finally joined a curtain on it. So ladies and gentlemen, at this point, I would like to invite to the podium for his vote of thanks, the current chairman of Flour Mills of Nigeria, PLC, Mr. John Coumantaros. A round of applause for him.
Your Excellencies, temporal, Your Excellencies, religious, governors, friends, dignitaries, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I would like to offer a vote of thanks to all of you who have traveled here today and spent this afternoon at the church and here at the reception to honor my late father, Mr. George S. Coumantaros. I would like to thank His Excellency Governor Ambode for his speech at the church, in which he offered my father to be the native son of Lagos. And His Excellency Governor Tambuwal of Sokoto, we are becoming a native son of Sokoto as well. And to all the distinguished guests that have traveled here today, General Danjuma and his lovely wife, Senator Danjuma, Daisy, Alhaji Joda, Philippa Siodu, Professor Ghana, Gilbert Shaguri. He was a dynamic man whose actions spoke volumes and who lived life to its fullest. I think the history has been gone into in the video, born in London, raised in Athens, to a Spartan father and a mother from the island of Santorini, where they have a twinkle in their eye and a spark in their step. He was from a family of flour millers and ship owners. The family left Greece during the Second World War, migrated to Argentina, and then came to the United States in 1946. So change, moving from one place to the other and starting all over again, was part of his history. So it was no surprise in 1960 when my grandfather and he met two Englishmen in the south of France, and they said, well, what do you do? We're in flour milling. We used to be in flour milling. The mill was destroyed in Greece. And they said, we've just come from newly independent Nigeria. They don't want the colonial British anymore. They want foreign investors. They don't want neo-colonial Americans. You're a Greek company, why don't you go and see what you can do? Back then in 1960, Nigeria was 35 million people. Today we are 180 plus. That's over five times. My mother would argue that Nigeria was his first home because she never saw him and he had his heart here in Nigeria. And in service to his adopted country, my father would always try and be of help. And I think Ahmed Joda told the story of the beginning of discussions of Biafra War of the ending of the Biafra War, but fundamentally he always believed that his fate and the fate of the nation were indelibly intertwined, and not just for business reasons. He really felt a tremendous love for Nigeria and for the hope and possibility of Nigeria for all. He had a tremendous love and admiration for Nigerian culture and people as a whole. And I think it's because he shared a very common attitude and approach to life and outlook. First, he was tremendously positive and optimistic. There wasn't a problem that was not solvable. The glass was always half full, and the sky was the limit. And I think that's how we think in Nigeria as well, a very optimistic and positive people. Secondly, he had tremendous tenacity, perseverance, and determination. We all know what it takes to get through 24 hours of life in Nigeria. You need a lot of determination, tenacity, and perseverance. So getting through life was tough. Thirdly, industriousness. He worked hard, and in Nigeria, everybody works hard. Fourth, humanity. He really liked people. He had confidence in people. He trusted people and felt what was good for all was good for him. And lastly, I'm going to say integrity. And I mean that an underlying belief and knowledge that in doing the right thing. And I think that integrity is deeply embedded in the Nigerian culture. Though many times we are prevented from getting there, we know what it is and we aspire to it. We see the city, the shining city on the hill, even though sometimes we have trouble reaching it. Nigeria afforded him opportunity to create great things, and he was a great creator with a vision and the ability to get things done. So my father was a great leader who set out his vision clearly without hesitation or change and expected you to get it done. To do it right and to do it now was his motto, and in this way he was very easy to follow. He had tremendous vision and foresight. We bought Kaboji Farms, 10,000 hectares again in Niger State, where we started to grow maize and soybean. But long after the phase of commercial farming had gone away and most people had sold their farms, my father insisted on keeping the farm. And every year at the budget meetings, the directors would say, you know, Mr. Coumantaros, Mr. Chairman, why are we having this Kaboji farm? We're losing money every year. Why don't we just get rid of it and stop it? And my father said, you know, agriculture is the laboratory. It's at the heart of 80% of what Nigerians do. And if we don't understand what that means, if we don't understand how that works and the whole ecosystem around it, then we will not have understood Nigeria. So we're keeping it. And it is a laboratory, it is an experiment, because this is the future of the country. My father's life was about integrity, hard work, and long-term thinking, just like Kaboji. It's not planting for yourself, but planting for your children and your children's children. I would add one final attribute, courage. He had tremendous courage. If he was here today, he would have thanked you all for being here, for taking your time, and for your effort in being here. And he would have said, don't shy away from the problems and obstacles facing the nation today. Face them with full front, with full force, upright, and have the courage to do the right thing, and you won't go wrong. Thank you very much.